Hey everybody, and welcome to the WWE Payback 2016 Pay-Per-View Predictions. I am EM Ultra Uprising, and I thank you for joining me here for watching the predictions video. I'm going to go down the card, quickly predict each and every match, give you what I think is going to happen, and a little bit of analysis on the build-up, etc. Thanks for watching here today. Be sure to give me a thumbs up, subscribe, and comment your own predictions down below. Let's get this video rolling with the pre-show match, U.S. title, Ryback versus Kalisto. And I'll be honest, I didn't even know this match was happening until I looked at the Payback card. So if that doesn't really tell you how little relevance goes into this match, I don't really know what does. It's really unfortunate because I think Kalisto versus Ryback could legitimately be a feud that could have some entertainment value to it, could potentially be something that I would enjoy. But here's where the issue lies for me. You don't do anything to build up the damn match, and I don't really care. So I'm not watching this. To be honest, I think Kalisto retains, but not really caring too much. So I'm not going to spend any more time on that. Let's go ahead and get into the rest of this card. We're going to talk about the three singles matches on the card and then the championship matches, or there's a number one contenders match, but I consider that in the championship tier, I guess you could say. So let's go ahead with the first singles match. We're going to save Sami Zayn versus Kevin Owens. Let's talk about Dolph Ziggler versus Baron Corbin. Now, Baron Corbin made his main roster debut after WrestleMania, where he won the Andre the Giant Memorial Battle Royal. And now that was nice for his career, potentially, and whatnot. But so far, I would say that his few weeks on Raw haven't been anything out of the ordinary or overly special. A feud with Dolph Ziggler doesn't really have the meaning in 2016 that it may have had maybe in 2012 or 13. Let's be honest. I don't think this is a terrible feud for Baron Corbin, but I'm not necessarily going to say it's a career starter for him either. I'm going to say Baron Corbin goes over Dolph Ziggler. I don't really see why he wouldn't. So not really a whole lot of crazy expectations for this match other than to really show off what Baron Corbin could do. So it could definitely be beneficial to Baron Corbin, but I don't see it as something like, oh my god, this is an amazing feud. Really isn't. Let's move on to the next matchup. Dean Ambrose versus Chris Jericho. Now this feud is kind of stemmed from, I guess, an argument over television shows, Shane McMahon writing Jericho's show right off of Raw, and now Ambrose Asylum taking its place. Now, some people have thought this feud seems a little bit ridiculous or a little bit far-fetched. I personally think it can do good for Ambrose, but like many others, I don't think it's an amazing feud for either person. Jericho has cut a couple of really good heel promos in the process, but when you're really fighting over a television program, inside of a television program, it does feel a little bit weird. It doesn't really have a personal edge to it, as you might want it to. Because to be completely honest, the idea of Dean Ambrose versus Chris Jericho could be a cool feud, considering it could extend back to a time when Jericho worked with Ambrose and Roman Reigns back in 2015. But, you know, we aren't going to go into the continuity thing. We're just going to forget that that entire thing happened and just move into 2016 where we're fighting over a TV talk show within a TV program. Alright, I guess that's how things have to be, WWE, whatever. Dean Ambrose should and probably will go over, so he will be who I pick to win this match. Next up, we're going to talk about Sami Zayn versus Kevin Owens, and this could honestly be the main event of the night because it's guaranteed going to be an awesome match. Now, anybody who's ever seen Sami Zayn versus Kevin Owens or El Generico versus Kevin Steen, you would know that these two guys have a ton of history and are amazing with one another in the ring. If you haven't seen one of their past matches, I highly recommend you do so immediately. I would pause this video and go watch one of their previous matches because they're so damn good. Sami Zayn and Owens are going to put on another good one here, and to be honest, the build-up has been underwhelming. This match deserved to be on WrestleMania, and the build-up should be better. It definitely is lacking. The build-up to their NXT title matches blew this build-up way out of the water, but at this point in time, I guess it's not all that shocking to see NXT actually surpassing main WWE roster stuff. It just isn't shocking anymore. Unfortunate, but true. So Sami Zayn versus Kevin Owens ought to be a good match. I'm sure it will be quite entertaining. But it's hard to predict who's going to win. I'm going to have to say I think Kevin Owens goes over here, and then Sami Zayn will probably get the revenge. I think they're going to extend this feud out, and it's going to go on for some time. So I'm going to say Kevin Owens gets the first victory as the heel, and then we continue it onward and forward. Either way, should be a great one. Tough one to call as to who will win. That makes me that much more excited to see what the outcome will be. But it certainly deserves to be at a bigger stage than Payback. But I will say, I'm still excited for the match. Not going to complain overall. At least we're getting it. At least we're getting it. What if we weren't getting it at all, right? I mean, that would be a hell of a lot worse. So I'm forever the eternal optimist. If I had any, like, you know, persona in the IWC, YWC, it would be the eternal optimist. I always want to look for the best in everything and try to see the positive side, which I feel a lot of reviewers don't try to do. They just, you know, flat out complain. And I mean, sometimes the complaints are deserved, but sometimes, hey, you know, let's just look at this realistically and say at least we're getting Sami Zayn versus Kevin Owens. It could be a hell of a lot worse, and we could be getting another multi-man match that doesn't really need to take place. Ahem, WrestleMania 32 ladder match. That was a rehash of the WrestleMania 31 ladder match. Anyway, let's get into the championship matches for the night. First with the number one contenders match. So we have Enzo Amore and Colin Cassady, S-A-W-F-T, versus the Vaudevillians. That the team of Aiden English and Simon Gotch. Two amazing teams coming from NXT. Very exciting to have these two teams up on the WWE main roster. And they've kept their gimmicks, and they're freaking entertaining. Whoa, holy crap, stop the presses. We got two entertaining tag teams going at it at Payback, and it's going to be a great match. And the winners get to face the New Day, who are freaking entertaining in of themselves, and New Day rocks. Do not forget that. So we got three awesome tag teams. I mean, wow, that's a lot more than we could probably say are in the main roster of the company at the same time in recent years. I think that it's fair to say. So yeah, this is going to be a pretty enjoyable match. I wonder if New Day will get involved in some way, shape, or form. I think the Vaudevillians are going to go over because Enzo and Cass have feuded a little bit with the Dudleys, so I think the Dudleys actually may be the team to get involved. And I think that the Vaudevillians end up facing New Day. It would make a little bit more sense since the Vaudevillians are taking on a heel persona. Enzo and Cass are freaking over on the main roster. It is unbelievable how Enzo Amore is so over so quickly, and he is just ridiculous. He's so entertaining, great promo. I love to see what this team can do here on the main roster in the future. Already off to an excellent start. This should be a hell of a match. This in of itself could be just a tag title match. Wow, great tag teams coming out of NXT, coming up to, and you still got more. You still got more coming. American Alpha is an unbelievable team down there as well. So, wow, good stuff, good stuff. Let's move on to the Intercontinental Championship match, which is Cesaro challenging The Miz. Now, this could be a pretty enjoyable match, too. I actually love Cesaro's new, like, Jason Statham type of gimmick, I guess you could say. He kind of comes out in the suit, just shoo, rips it off, and then is ready for action. Pretty damn cool type of gimmick. I mean, he does fit the part of that, like, secret agent type of, like, I'm gonna fuck everybody up type of look. And that's exactly what Cesaro should be. So him versus Miz, I'm fine with this match for the IC title. In fact, I think we're going to get a title change already. I think we're going to see Cesaro take the belt. I actually wouldn't be upset with Miz retaining here and this feud going on for another few weeks. Because to me, Miz is an enjoyable heel character, and I think we've seen a little bit of that. And Maryse helps to bring out the best in the Miz. I actually am really happy that she's back to help be the valet for the Miz. I think that's really interesting and adds a little bit of an extra layer to the IC title picture. This feud hasn't been built up unbelievably well. It's not one of those feuds where I sit there and say, oh my god, praise the Lord, it's a great IC title match. It really isn't like an unbelievable feud, but it's a match that I will say I'm looking forward to and think could be an enjoyable one. Cesaro always puts on good matches, and Miz is honestly an underrated worker in my opinion. So I'm going to say Cesaro goes over and wins the IC title, but I could definitely see Miz retaining as well. And to kind of backtrack for a second, I really did like the tag team title stuff because there was a tournament. And again, it makes things feel a little bit different. It's fresh, it's different, it's new, and it shows off how WWE has a diverse and deep tag division, which is the first time we could say that in quite some time. And Primo and Epico are coming back too, which is definitely better than Los Matadores. So hey, we got things getting in, definitely going in a better direction overall. So now let's move on from the IC title match to the women's championship match. We have Natalya challenging Charlotte for the title. Natalya will have Bret Hart in her corner, and of course, Charlotte will have Rick motherfucking Flair in her corner. And this should be a great match. Now, Natalya and Charlotte have already put on some great matches in the past, a couple on the main roster and in NXT. And I'm sure this one will get up to that level. But I'm going to go ahead and say that Charlotte retains once again. She hangs on to the championship for longer. I don't think Natalya is the person that will win the belt from Charlotte. I think they're trying to make Charlotte feel like this big, bad, women's champion who is hard to beat and flat out, you know, kind of mirrors her dad, always a step ahead of the competition, and then someone will finally end it. And I don't think Natalya is going to be the one to do it. I would like to see Natalya do it. To be honest, I've always been a big fan of hers, and she's only really won one championship, if I remember right, and that was several years ago. So to see Natalya win the title here with Bret Hart in her corner would be a pretty cool moment at Payback. I think it would be a great moment, because then you could put the belt right back on Charlotte a few weeks later. So to me, it'd actually be a fine booking decision to have Natalya win the championship here. But I don't think it's going to happen. I'm going to say Charlotte retains. The build-up here has been up and down. There's been a couple weeks where I was like, oh, okay, there's something going on here. And then a couple of weeks where there really wasn't much happening at all. Like, for example, the go-home show. It was kind of like a quick match with Natalya. She wins, stares at Charlotte, and it's like, yeah, let's just move on. So I'm more excited for the match itself than any of the build-up to it, but there's definitely some history between the two. Of course, WWE doesn't do an amazing job of explaining that history, the continuity issues again. But I'm going to say I'm glad this match is happening, so I'm definitely looking forward to it as a women's championship match. I'm certain that it will be good. So Charlotte, I'm going to say, will retain. And I think we have gone over every match now, just quickly double-checking, and now we are into the main event. The World Heavyweight Championship on the line. AJ Styles challenging, it sounded like I had an accent there, AJ Styles challenging Roman Reigns for the championship. And so, I think that this could be a great match. I don't think the build-up here has been spectacular. It hasn't. It really hasn't. But the Bullet Club, or Gallows and Anderson, I don't want to say the wrong thing for WWE's terms, but the Bullet Club have been involved with AJ. They've attacked Roman Reigns. It's interesting dynamic. Will they interfere at Payback? Honestly, there's probably been more build and more relevancy to whether or not they're going to get involved in this match than there actually has been on the focus of AJ versus Roman. AJ versus Roman for two or three different weeks didn't really feel like it was a match that was a feud of any sort. It really just kind of felt like AJ's winning his matches and doing his thing, and Roman's winning matches and doing his thing. So they're both winning matches, and they both have momentum. That's all nice, well, fine, and good. But I haven't really seen a whole lot of face-to-face interaction with them, except for the last 2 weeks, when AJ was just like, dude, I didn't tell them to attack you. And then this week, when the show ended with Styles delivering the forearm, I would have liked to have seen a little bit more dynamic between the two. It's tough because neither one is a great talker, but maybe a contract signing, something additional. I don't know, I just think the build-up has felt kind of lackluster, especially when you consider the fact that this is for the WWE World Heavyweight Championship. You do have a little bit of a higher expectation that the build-up is going to be at a higher level than, say, everything else, because it's supposed to be the main event. When you, as a fan and as a consumer, are actually more intrigued as to whether or not the Bullet Club or maybe Finn Balor is going to get involved in this match than you are as to who's going to win it, that's a little bit of a backtrack. That's not really a good thing, because the focus isn't on the championship. The focus is on everything around it. So to me, I think the focus is a little bit off-center here, but I am excited for whether or not the Bullet Club will interfere, whether it's to turn on Styles or to help him, or if Finn Balor will come in with them and maybe all of them are against AJ and they're a heel group. I think that could be an interesting dynamic. You could have a lot of things going here. And the Usos were involved with Roman Reigns. Will they get themselves into this whole thing too? There could be a lot going on in this main event. So definitely a cool picture. I'm going to say Roman Reigns walks out with the championship though. I don't see AJ Styles winning it here already. Roman, they did all the work that they did to build Roman to winning the title at WrestleMania. I just don't see them turning around and dropping the belt off of him a few weeks later. It's very clear to me that even though he's getting such a negative reception from all the crowds, he's still the guy. They still want to push him to the top. They still want him to be their you know, new representative, the guy going forward. I'm interested to see where this whole thing will go once John Cena returns, because I think that Cena is going to ultimately end up back in this main event scenario, where Roman Reigns is basically going to have to be a heel at that point, because I feel that John Cena is going to get less boos than Roman Reigns. If, I'm not going to lie, the crowd's not going to know what to do. They're not going to know whether to boo John Cena or Roman Reigns, and could that be an interesting dynamic? Absolutely could. So I think this Styles-Reigns match definitely has potential to be quite good. The focus is definitely on more or less what kind of BS or fuckery is going to come about. I mean, I'm interested in it, though. I can't say I'm not interested in the match. So they have me interested, but I don't know if the focus is in the right area, because I'm not really all that concerned about the championship, which is supposed to be the bigger thing here. Just saying. Anyway, I'm looking forward to Payback. This is a better card than what you may expect for the pay-per-view after WrestleMania. I'm glad there's not a shit ton of rematches from WrestleMania. I'm glad there's some individual different feuds, a chance for Baron Corbin to shine, a chance for Ambrose to get a victory for himself, Zayn and Owens in a match, oh my god. Vaudevillians and Enzo and Cass in a tag match, that's going to be cool. Charlotte and Natalya should be good. Miz and Cesaro definitely has potential. Reigns and Styles definitely. Like, every match on the card has potential to be really good. So I'm looking forward to Payback. I think this could be quite a good pay-per-view. Could be a hit-or-miss type of night, too. I'm not really sure what we're going to get, but I definitely want to know what your guys' predictions are down in the comments section below. Thank you for watching very much. Be sure to hit that thumbs-up button, and of course, subscribe if you haven't yet. I'm on the journey to try to get to 1,000 subscribers. We're 30 away. Let's get this going. I want to get there, because then after that, I'm going to introduce a couple of different elements on this channel, which I really look forward to. New video types and styles, and a different format for how reviews are going to be going. So, thank you very much for watching, as always, guys. I'll be back with a Payback review after the pay-per-view goes off air. Hope you guys enjoyed, and until then, have a wonderful weekend. Peace.